Welcome back to HHO Gas Technology. Today we are going to be demonstrating removing a bleeder screw on a caliper on a 2006 Chevrolet HHR. We are using the EP230. In the machine it has oxyhydrogen, and in the fossil fuel bubbler it's got hexane. We got it leaned out. You can see that knob is turned all the way out, making it run lean. So we have a lean mixture with the oxyhydrogen. And that's the pressure we have it set for, internal pressure. Around 10 psi. Out of the machine, the gas goes through our dryer system. Flashback arrestor, get this out of the way. Flashback arrestor. And then our jeweler's torch. Very fine tip. And grab it. Very small. Here's my finger. We're using our HD camera today. It's smaller than a basketball filler adapter. We are going to be removing this bleeder screw right here on a 2006 Chevrolet HHR. Has never been removed since 2006 for any reasons. We just put some WD-40 on it to make sure we can break it loose. Most of the time that does not work, so we're going to heat it up and evaporate all that WD-40 all the way into the threads. We're going to expand the outside a little bit without damaging any rubber material around it or damaging the caliper or the seal inside. Set it up on the tripod, start the process. Adjust it. We are dealing with pinpoint accuracy flame. No other torch can do this. You cannot make a small hairline size flame to do what this is going to do. Going to light the torch. You see how small that flame is. But it's longer than it appears, look. Look at that turn red hot, just instantly on contact. Should finds the right length. This small of a flame will melt concrete. You see the blue tip on it? That's because we have a fossil fuel in the mixture. Give this a little bit wider flame. Pinpoint. I got years of experience doing all kinds of automobile repair jobs. That should be good. Be able to break that loose right now. Broke loose, waiting for the fluid to come out. Here comes the fluid. Look at that. Try doing that with a propane torch or oxygen and acetylene. You can't. With the tip that size, look at that. Look at that size, look at me. I'm gonna put that in there so you can see how small it is. Another job done with oxyhydrogen. We could have done it with 100% oxyhydrogen, but we wanted that little fossil fuel for just a wider tip, because it'd been more pinpoint. Thank you for watching. Peter Crunk, HHO Gas Technology. If anybody's looking for anything for the automobile industry, for repairing in the garages, shops, and all kinds of stuff, give me a call. Business 313-355-6193. You can contact me during business hours, 9 to 5 Eastern Time. We will bring one to your shop if you're locally in the Detroit area for you to try it before buying it. Like I said, seeing it before, seeing it work, will convince you, wow. It definitely surpasses the fossil fuel technology that's been around for 50 more years, and now we have oxyhydrogen that surpasses it today. So that's the new technology for today. I don't know why it's not being used widely, but it's time to change. As you can see, there was no smoke when I was burning off that WD-40. Thank you for watching. Peter Crunk out for now.